We are going to talk about one of the important integral transforms is Fourier transforms. In this session, we have to know the Fourier integrals and their formulae. We need to know the formulae related to Fourier transforms. The only thing you need to know is some important identities that are very much essential in finding Fourier integral identities and also Fourier transforms. You have to be thorough with the properties of Fourier transforms. Now let us get into the details. Integral transforms are very much useful in solving initial value problems as well as boundary value problems. And integral transforms are very much essential in evaluating certain kind of integrals. The benefit is obvious since the present study will also be very helpful in solving ordinary differential equations and partial differential equations of non-periodic functions. It is one of the very important key point regarding Fourier transforms. Fourier series decomposes a periodic function into a discrete set of contributions of different frequencies. That is, all multiples of one fundamental frequency is to be considered. Apart from this, a Fourier transform provides us a continuous frequency resolution of a possibly non-periodic function. So that is the major benefit from the Fourier transform. Laplace transform is the most important integral transform in science and engineering. All of us are familiar with it. From this point of view, in applications, one of the very important mathematical tool is the Fourier transform. In this connection, the choice of a particular transform that is to be used for the solution of a differential equation, which is depend upon the nature of the boundary conditions of the equation. Now, the facility with which the transform a function in terms of the parameter S can be converted to produce a function in terms of the variable X, that is the advantage by the Fourier transform. Fourier transforms are widely used in science and technology. Basically, the theories of communication engineering, we have utilized the Fourier transforms. You can see here, this is only communication engineering related things. And Fourier transforms can be used in wave propagation. And they are used in transmission lines also. And Fourier transforms are widely utilized in the frequency response of a filter. And finally, they are used in the finding solution of partial differential equations. Let us discuss the formula related to Fourier integrals. Fourier integral theorem. A function f of x that is piecewise continuous in every finite interval in the domain negative infinity, positive infinity. And that function f of x is absolutely integrable in this domain negative infinity, positive infinity. What is absolutely integrable? That is, integral negative infinity to positive infinity mod f of x dx is finite, then this function f of x is absolutely integrable in this domain. For example, f of x is e power negative x is an absolutely integrable function over this interval. F of x is e power x is non-absolutely integrable function over this interval. F of x is 1 by pi integral 0 to infinity integral negative infinity to positive infinity f of t cosine s times of t negative x dt ds is called the Fourier integral of the function f of x. So f of x 1 by pi integral 0 to infinity integral negative infinity to positive infinity f of t cosine s t negative x dt ds is called only the Fourier generalized integral of the function f of x. Fourier cosine integral as well as sine integral. Fourier cosine integral of the function f of x is f of x equals to 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity integral 0 to infinity f of t cosine st dt cosine sx ds. Fourier sine integral of the function f of x equals to 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity again integral 0 to infinity f of t sine st dt sine sx ds. The complex form of Fourier integral, it can be used very rarely. F of x is 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity again integral 0 to infinity f of t cosine lambda t cosine lambda x dt d lambda. One of the important key point regarding Fourier integrals is the Fourier integral representation to the function f of x which is converges to the function f of x at the points of continuity. At the points of continuity, the Fourier integral representation to the function f of x is always converges to the function that is defined at x. The Fourier integral representation of the function f of x that is converges to the average of the function at positive values of x and a function that is defined at negative values of x at the points of discontinuity. At the points of discontinuity, the Fourier integral representation of the function that is converges to f of x plus plus f of x negative over 2. Let us discuss the formula related to Fourier transforms. Fourier transform of f of x is 1 by square root 2 pi integral negative infinity to positive infinity the function f of x and its kernel e power isx dx. That equals to Fourier transform of s, where s is the parameter, x is the variable. Inverse Fourier transform f of x equals to 1 by square root 2 pi integral negative infinity to positive infinity function in terms of the parameter s. Here the kernel is e power negative I s x ds. Fourier sine transform of f of x is square root 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity the function f of x and its kernel sine sx dx. That equals to f of s over s. Inverse Fourier transform of this function f of x equals to square root 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity f of s over s sine sx ds. Fourier cosine transform of f of x is square root 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity the function f of x cosine sx dx that equals to f of s over c. Inverse Fourier cosine transform will be f of x is square root 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity f of s over c cosine sx ds. Important identities that are very much essential in finding Fourier integrals and Fourier transforms. They are integral 0 to infinity e power negative x square dx is square root pi by 2. Integral 0 to infinity sine cos kx by x dx is pi by 2 if k is positive constant, negative pi by 2 if k is negative. Suppose we consider k as 1. Integral 0 to infinity sin x by x dx is pi by 2 since k is equal to 1, that is positive. E power ax plus e power negative ax by 2 is cosine h ax. E power ax negative e power negative ax by 2 is sin h ax. E power iax plus e power negative iax over 2 is cosine ax, where e power iax is cosine ax plus I sine ax according to Euler's theorem. E power negative iax is cosine ax negative I sine ax by Euler's theorem. E power iax negative e power negative iax by 2i is sine ax. And we need to know the important trigonometric relations. Sine of a plus b plus sine of a minus b is 2 sine a cosine b. Sine of a plus b minus sine of a minus b is 2 cosine a sine b. Cosine of a plus b plus cosine of a minus b is 2 cosine a cosine b. Cosine of a minus b minus cosine of a plus b is 2 sine a sine b. Now I just want to tell you the important properties of Fourier transforms. First one is the linearity property. If Fourier transform of f of x is f of s and Fourier transform of another function g of x is g of s, then Fourier transform of a into f of x plus b into g of x is a times of Fourier transform of f of x plus b times of Fourier transform of g of x, where a and b are constants. That equals to a times of Fourier transform of f of x is f of s plus b times of g of s. Next one, Fourier cosine transform of a into f of x plus b times of g of x equals to a times of Fourier cosine transform of f of x plus b times of Fourier cosine transform of g of x. Fourier sine transform of a into f of x plus b times of g of x equals to a times of Fourier sine transform of f of x plus b times of Fourier sine transform of g of x. What is the self-reciprocal? When do we say that the given function f of x is self-reciprocal? If the Fourier transform of the function f of x is some scalar multiple of f of s, then the function f of x is said to be self-reciprocal. Shifting property in the variable x. Let us see Fourier transform of a function that is in terms of x negative a equals to e power ias Fourier transform of f of x, where I is imaginary number, that is square root negative 1, a is constant,
s is the parameter, that equals to e power is f of s. Change of scale property. The Fourier transform of f of x, where x is the variable, a is constant, that equals to 1 by a Fourier transform of s by a, where a is positive constant. Fourier cosine transform of f of x is 1 by a Fourier cosine transform of s by a. Fourier sine transform of f of x, that is 1 by a Fourier sine transform of s by a. Shifting in the parameter s. Fourier transform of e power I x f of x is f of s plus a. Fourier transform of e power I a x f of x is f of s plus a, where a constant, s is the parameter.
Modulation property. Fourier transform of cosine ax f of x is 1 by 2 f of s plus a plus f of s negative a, where s is the parameter, a is the constant. Now Fourier cosine transform of f of x cosine ax is 1 by 2 f of s plus a over c plus f of s negative a over c. Fourier sine transform of f of x cosine ax is 1 by 2 f of s negative a over s plus f of s plus a over s. Fourier cosine transform of f of x sine ax is 1 by 2 f of s plus a over s negative f of s negative a over s. Fourier sine transform of f of x sine ax is 1 by 2 f of s negative a over c negative f of s plus a over c. Fourier transform of derivative property. Fourier transform of the first derivative of the function at the variable x is negative is f of s, where I is imaginary number, s is the parameter, f of s is a Fourier transform of given function f of x. And also Fourier cosine transform of the first derivative to the function f of x is s into f of s of f of x negative square root 2 by pi f of 0. Fourier sine transform of first derivative to the function f of x is negative s Fourier cosine transform of f of x. Next, the property regarding derivative of transform. Fourier transform of x power n into f of x, that is the function f of x is multiplicated by x power n, is negative I power n, nth derivative to the f of s, where f of s is called Fourier transform of f of x. Fourier cosine transform of x into f of x is the first derivative to the Fourier sine transform of f of x, that is f of s over s. And Fourier sine transform of x into f of x is the first derivative to Fourier cosine transform of f of x, that is f of s over c.